Good morning. Who's up out there? Hello? Hi, guys. Oh, my goodness. Monday again, huh? Who's ready for Monday? Who's ready for Monday? Because you already started. There's no going back. How are you guys doing? Let me tell you a little bit about me. It's raining where I am, which is not bad. Rain is good. I feel like it cleans a little bit of things. At least that's how I see it in my head. I woke up early. I did my 30 minutes of yoga. That was nice. I meditated, and then I went to Target. I went to my store. I bought, I restocked my pantry. I was running out of the usual paper towel, napkins. I bought, what did I get? I also got something I really wanted. I was very happy I found it. Oh, one of those little things that you put like little pieces of bamboo that smells like, I forgot what it's called exactly. But it's one of those like smelly things for the house. Now that we're here all day and I'm cooking and, you know, you have all these odors, and I bought, I also got some air purifier too. So it kind of purifies the air, and we could, you know, and then smells good, and then all this great things are going on. So I got all this stuff at the store. I was very happy because nobody was there, so I was able to go in and out with my gloves. That was nice. No lines with like 6 feet between you know, each one of us. So that was really nice to go. Like little things that you now don't take for granted, like going to the store without having to go on in line to get in. So that was really nice. And then I came home. My son is home, and he's doing school online. So I had to wake him up to make sure that he was ready for it. And he was halfway there, halfway up. So I make sure that he was fully up and up and running. And then I made myself a little iced coffee home, because first of all, I haven't gone to Starbucks in so long. Like, I seriously never go. I think it's extremely expensive, and I think it's basically for coffee. I mean, unless you're really on the run and are like, you know, I don't know, desperate, just coffee in Starbucks is like insanely expensive. Actually, I made the math once. Like, I think it's like $5, the average coffee in Starbucks. And I did a calculation, 5 times. Let's see, because there's some people that drink coffee every day, and I find that insane. And I mean, 5 times 30 equals 150, right? A month plus 12 is like $1,800 in coffee a year. So I remember I did that, and I found it so expensive. Like $1,800 in coffee? It's not even like the best coffee. But anyway, I thought, oh my God, that's insane. Oh, if you want to have like coffee and a bagel, or coffee and something, it's like, I remember it was like 2,000 something. It was like insane amount of money for coffee and banana bread. So it's, I don't know. It turned me off with coffee big time. And so I started making my own coffee at home, which is, you know, normal, just nothing insane. And I just make it every day. Just this one is iced coffee, and And I get here, I get to work, and I get to see what's happening. I get to read some of your comments and things like that. And, you know, it's been pretty inspiring hearing you guys and how you guys are, you know, dealing with these difficult times in which we don't know what's happening and how this is going to turn out or when it's going to end. And all these beautiful things I hear from you. I just wanted to tell you that I'm very grateful, because, you know, we already have so much bad news, like so many, like nothing, not many things are very positive and lively nowadays. I had to rely a lot on my books and stories and movies and great shows that you watch and just little things to entertain your mind during these difficult times and to hear your thoughts and comments and how you're handling these difficult times. It's very, very cool. And I just want to say thank you, because it makes me feel like I'm not on my own. I mean, I hear so many times like, oh, Danai, you're so positive. Oh, Danai, how? I'm like, I don't know if I'm positive. I just try to make the best out of this situation. I mean, what is being positive nowadays? Positive is just, it's just dealing with what you've got from your, you know, from your personal situation. I mean, it's just, you have two choices to like, just be negative and be positive. And what is being negative? Being negative is like just thinking the worst it could happen, thinking that you will not have a job, thinking that you will not have ever see your friends or your family anymore. Like it just doesn't help the situation. So I always find very interesting how people tell me that I'm always very positive. I'm like, what do you want me to think? Like the worst? Like I just refuse that. I think I'm very hopeful towards my world and towards the people that are around me, and the fact that you guys are also positive, and that I inspire some of that in you, and you certainly inspire some of it in me. It makes me feel like I'm not alone, and it matters a lot, especially when you can't move, can't go anywhere. You're really living these weird times, and I just want to say thank you for that. And this week is gonna be another week of, you know, quarantine, as far as I know, and how we are gonna, you know, take a day at a time. Let's keep up this positive energy. I'm very much looking forward to keep creating my routine. I do yogas in the morning, I meditate, and then I read. I'm writing a lot right now, which has been very healing and very isolating. I've been cooking, as you guys can see. And I've been running when it's not raining. I've just been taking care of myself. I do my nails. I do my nails and my toenails. I do a little self-care here and there every day. I've been taking baths with Epsom salt and what else did I do? Epsom salt and lavender. And it's been an interesting, you know, journey so far. What about you guys? What are you doing for self-care and for, you know, your days? What do you do throughout your days now? What do you do? Talk to me. Oh, from Bulgaria. Do you speak Spanish? Yes, I do speak Spanish. It's me, Ruby, is telling me to do more cooking. Yes, you're right. I just made a banana bread yesterday. And after I did it, I was like, I think next time I make another banana bread, I'm going to share it with you guys. But yes, I'm going to cook more. I'm going to show you guys a couple of tricks for sure. Do you watch TV shows? Yes, I do. I'm watching, actually, I'm watching Ozark. It's really good. I'm watching Ozark. I'm in episode 7. It's not bad. And if you haven't seen it, I don't want to spoil it for you. But it's a very dark, it's turning dark this year. I mean, it's always been dark, but it's just the work that the actors are doing. Jason Bateman, Laura Linney, Julia Gardner, I think it is her name. She's fantastic. Such a great cast. So well done. I'm Hayda Jess. She's walking her dogs. Oh, she's such a sweetheart. Oh, this is such a sweet girl. Yes, I don't have dogs, but I want to get one. I want to get a dog. I'll walk too. Anyway, Ozark. Yes, Ozark is really good. I also started watching Tiger King. Oh my gosh, have you guys seen Tiger King? Like, that's crazy. I mean, I don't know. I don't want to, again, I don't want to spoil it for you, but if you get to watch Tiger King, it's this basically the story of three people that really don't like each other because they're basically in competition with each other, that they raise tigers, like big cats, like huge lions and tigers and everything I'm terrified of. Like, that's what they raise. Like, and they have like 200 tigers. Like, it's crazy. And there's one lady, she lives in Florida. Another one lives in Michigan. No, it's not Michigan. Anyway, they live in three different parts of in the U.S. And they have like little, it could be like a zoo. Like, people actually go in and get to touch baby tigers and all this stuff. So, but the entire, how they deal with each other, they hate each other so much. It, like, the lady wanna close this other guy, Joe, the zoo, because she doesn't believe that he's being kind to animals, and then but at the same time she has like 500 tigers too. And anyway, oh god, I'm in episode 1, 2, and it's incredibly fascinating. I don't know if you guys like tigers, but I'm terrified of tigers and sharks. Like, those are the two things that I just don't want to be around. If I can, I'd rather to have zombies around than a tiger or a shark. Okay, but that was really good. So I watched that. I watched Tiger King. I watched Ozark. I watched Succession. That was really good. If you haven't seen Succession, it's amazing. It's on HBO. What else is that out there? Somebody's saying that I like tigers only on screen, not in person. Have you seen The Servant? I haven't seen The Servant. Oh, yes. This beautiful girl from Germany, she's asking me, the Comic-Con in Dortmund, I was gonna go, but it got canceled because of the whole coronavirus. If they postpone it for another date past coronavirus, I will certainly be there. Definitely for those of you that are in Europe, and the other side of, the U.S., I would certainly try to go there for sure. I really wanted to be there in Europe, like around May, just to also spend a couple of weeks after that, because usually that's around the time that I stop shooting Fear. But I'm hoping that they postpone it for another date, and they, and that we can make that date. because it will be so fun for sure. I will go to Europe, so I will keep you posted with that. Okay, any other question? Yes, it will be wonderful to see you too. Any other question? Hi from Italy. Oh, sending my big love to Italy, and it's Spain and France. I mean, the entire Europe. I mean, guys, you guys are my heroes. Hang in there. Hang really strong. I mean, it's difficult times over there, and it's gonna come. It's gonna go through. Okay, I promise. But for now, just receive my love, my hugs, from me. Just so you know that as soon as I get a chance to go do any conventions, I would certainly be happy to be there to give you a hug in person, and to tell you that you're loved, and to tell you that thank you for being so strong during these difficult times. But in between all that, just keep strong. You can do this. You guys are amazing. Hola desde Honduras, Centroamérica. Un abrazo para Honduras y toda Latinoamérica que están aquí conmigo ahora. Los quiero mucho. I'm from Japan. Hi, Japan. Hello from France. Hi, France. What do you think about Italy? Oh, hello from Cuba. Hola, Cuba. What do I think about Italy? It's that it's devastating. It's devastating what's happening. I mean, it really is. It's something that it's... I just recently did an interview that talks about this precisely. Like, what is the difference between the apocalypse that we're living now versus the apocalypse that we live on the show? Well, on the show, guys, we see zombies. They're infected. You run away from them. You hide from them. You kill them. You get rid of the virus, right? Because it's visually, you can see it. But in this situation, we don't know what the virus is. So abstract. So you have to go out with gloves, and it could be in a counter. It could be in anything you touch. I mean, imagine you go to the store, and I mean, what are you gonna do? You have to pick up the stuff that you're gonna go and buy, and the virus could be on top of a toilet paper for all I know. I mean, what am I going to do? And I can see it. I just went to the store and I was thinking about that. I was like, this thing could be anywhere. This is ridiculous. I can't. It doesn't have a color. It doesn't have a smell. It's just a virus. So I'm like, I mean, I think it's more dangerous than our actual apocalypse on the show. I really do. Because you can't see it. It's not a good feeling. And so anyway, I we can protect ourselves. All we have to do is keep washing our hands and, you know, protect ourselves in at home. So it's another extremely isolating experience that, you know, we have to keep sane and keep being connected, which is something we don't have in the apocalypse. We don't have internet. We cannot FaceTime or do Instagram lives. We can't do that. So that's a good plus that we have going on here. We can be connected. So yeah, that's what I think about both apocalypse. It's something weird. What do you think about Prison Break? Prison Break is, for those of you that don't know, Prison Break is a show that I was part of on season 3. It's a show that is huge worldwide. So for those of you that haven't seen it, you must check it out. It's a really good show. What do I think of it? I think it's one of the best shows in the world. I mean, it has the best talent, it has the best crowd, it has the best fans, the most loyal fans, so it's pretty amazing, and I hope that they come back, because they stopped now. I mean, everything stopped, right? But I hope that it come back, because I'm always curious to see where these people are going next. These are characters that you're so invested in them, and yeah, I think is amazing. And I love everyone in it. What do you think about Brazilian fans? You guys are amazing. Brazilians, all the fans that I have. I mean, you guys are the best. I was thinking, of doing something fun for you guys. What do you think? I can't drive. I'm gonna give you a hint. I can drive. So, I'm going to do a little karaoke here. How about that? This is the new song that I really like. Okay. My secret weapon has just arrived. This is a good one. I don't know who's ready for this. I wasn't thinking of it, but I was just thinking. Camino, yo no sé de poesía, ni de filosofía. Solo sé que tu vida, yo la quiero la mía. ¿Cómo hacer para no tenerte la gana que te tengo? ¿Cómo hacer para no quererte? Yeah. Tú, nadie como tú, no hay un sustituto. Para ese tiempo tuyo que a mí me tiene cucu. Un rato te busco y un día curruco. Yeah. Nadie como tú. Como tú, no hay nadie como tú. Nadie como tú, no hay un sustituto para el furgotillo que a mí no tiene cucu. Es un toque de gusto y te acurruco. Yeah, nadie como tú, pues no hay nadie como tú, no hay nadie como tú, no hay nadie como tú. Oh my God, that's a good song. That is a good song. That's a good song. I really love the tutu song. And I'm going to do another one for you guys. Just so you start the entire week. Because, I mean, I never gotten so many... requests about... karaoke. Never. Or anything that I've done. So I'm gonna give you a little bit of your favorites today to start the Monday energized. Okay?
I don't believe in the phrase aspiring writer.
Let's see. That's not karaoke. That's a... I'm sure you guys remember this.
Sabes que ya llevo un rato mirándote. Tengo que bailar contigo hoy. Vi que tu mirada ya estaba llamándome. Muéstrame el camino que yo voy. Oh, tú eres el imán y yo soy el metal. Me voy acercando y me voy armando el plan. Solo con pensarlo me acelera el pulso. Oh yeah, ya me está gustando más de lo normal. Todos mis sentidos van pidiendo más. Esto hay que tocarlo sin ningún apuro. Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuerpo despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído, para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, quiero destinarte despacito. Firme en las paredes de tu laberinto y hacer de tu cuerpo un manuscrito. Deja de bailar tu cuerpo, quiero ser tu ritmo. Que le enseñes a mi boca lugares favorito, baby. Déjame sobrepasar tus dudas y peligros, hasta provocar tus gritos y que olvides mi apellido. Si te pido un beso, ven, dámelo. Yo sé que estás pensando, llevo tiempo inventando. Mami, te estoy inventando. Sabes que tu cuerpo es un lugar de bam bam. Sabes que sabes que está buscando de mi bam bam. Boca para ver cómo te sabe. Quiero ver cómo a ti te cabe. Yo no tengo prisa, quiero dar el viaje. Empezamos dentro de este salvaje. Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito, nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito. Cuando tú regresas con esa destreza, pero quieres malicia con delicadeza. Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito, nos vamos llevando poquito a poquito. Ya que se oye, es un rompecabezas, pero para montarlo aquí tengo la pieza. Oye, despacito, deja que te diga cosas al oído, para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Despacito, quiero desnudarte todo despacito, firma las paredes de tu laberinto y hacer de tu cuerpo todo un manuscrito. Quiero que bailar tu pelo, quiero ser tu ritmo, que le enseñes a mi boca lugares favoritos. Déjame sobrepasar tus zonas de peligro, hasta provocar tus gritos y que des tu apellido. Despacito, vamos a hacerle en una playa en Puerto Rico, hasta que las olas griten ay bendito, para que mi sello se quede contigo. Lugares favoritos, suavecito, nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito. Que olvides tu apellido, despacito. Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito, nos vamos pegando poquito a poquito.
Okay, that was a little bit crazy. I'm hoping I didn't wake up anybody here. If I did, who cares? but thank you very much. Let me do my little bow. Anyway, I just wanted to tell you guys that I'm very grateful to have you around during this time. We should definitely do this more often. We should definitely do a little karaoke session now that I can't like drive because we can't get out. So that doesn't mean that karaoke has to stop, okay? Because I used to do karaoke when I was on my way commuting to places. So send me a little, you know, direct message and tell me what songs you want me to sing next time. and let's have fun. Let's just do this in the morning. I mean, it's morning for me. It might be evening for you guys. So let's try to energize ourselves before for me before my day starts, but for you before you you guys go to bed, just to get a little bit of love here from me to you through good talks. Oh, I'm gonna sneeze. It went away. No. I was going to, but it didn't happen. Anyway, thank you so much for being around, for being here. For those of you that are into terrible circumstances like Italy, much worse than here, stay strong. I'm there giving you guys love. Think of this karaoke. And I'll see you, what if in 2 days would be a good time? 2 days in the morning? I love you guys. Thank you for being there. Thank you for being so amazing. And stay strong. You guys are the best. Receive a big love from me whenever you are. And I'm around. Let me know what good talks you guys want to talk about next time in 2 days, and what songs you guys would like me to sing. Oh, we can sing it together. Okay? Love, love from me to you. Stay strong and stay safe and stay home. Mwah.